Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, fight number 9 of the evening. It's time to get the girls out here in the center ring. Oh, yeah, you know what I'm talking about. So here we go, representing Dynamite Muay Thai with a fight record of 8 wins, 4 losses, 1 draw, weighing in at 48.7 kilograms, trained by Dennis O'Day. Please welcome Zia Sorkati.
Quarter mil, no sweat, last time that I checked. I'm the streets voice out west, legendary self-made progress. Last time that I checked, first get the money, the respect, and the power in the halls come next. Last time
that I checked,
I've been self-made from the dribble.
Zia, Sean McPhee from Dynamite Gym, and my good friend there, Dennis O'Day. Weighing at 48 kilos, 8 wins, 4 losses, and 1 draw.
On the whole thing for you niggas, reinvest, double up, then explain for you niggas, it gotta be love. Run the city, it gotta be cut. Spot the pieces out the bottom and not when you pour. Hey, y'all niggas, false claims, it gotta be four. Keep the word about your mouth and you gotta be charged.
Her opponent fighting out of the red corner, weighing in at 48.4 kilograms. With a fight record of 7 wins and 2 losses. Trained out of martial spirit by Spring Seer and the team, Z Rowlandson. Three by 2 minute rounds, sponsored by First Choice Car Wash. Both fighters are Waku Rembo.
And the tail of the tape, if you're watching the tail of the tape, guys, we have Zia Sorkati from Dynamite Gym, trained by Dennis O'Day, with 8 wins, 4 losses, 1 draw. And in the red corner there we have ZZ Rowlandson from Martial Spirit. Spring Sia, 7 wins, 2 losses. Both girls are weighing at 48 kilos. This fight is proudly sponsored by First Choice Car Wash.
Fantastic to see the girls getting in center ring. All the way down to the 48 kilo mark. It's been an absolute cracking night of fight so far. For those watching at home, you can hear the noise in the background. The support is insane here. Every fighter that has been matched on the card tonight has really brought the fans into the house. It's a sold out arena here at the Hardcore Promotions Muay Thai Fight Night. Another couple of fantastic gyms going head to head. Dynamite Muay Thai with Dennis O'Day in the corner. And in the other one, we got Martial Spirit, another staunch Muay Thai gym, really producing a lot of fantastic fighters. Spring Sear, one of the headliner names. We'll be seeing her a little later on in tonight's title fight as both girls go to the final rituals of the removing of the Mong Kong. Final blessings given to them by their trainer. We're second out, and we're going to be coming to you with bout number 9.
See ZZ there, center ring, ZZ Rowlandson, who once upon a time was standing down, training under myself there at the Power Play Gymnasium.
We are seconds out for round 1.
ZZ coming out strong with the sweep, taking her down. Rice right hand and right leg kick. Once again.
Two very fast, very agile, and very tiny females. So, I mean, only 48 kilos apiece, but geez, they are making up. Look at the speed on them, Joe Nader.
Now, your leg weighs more than them.
Yeah, but they could probably throw it a lot faster.
Probably so, yeah.
Whilst I'm on the broadcast, just want to throw a shout out to my old-time sparring partner. He's watching us live as we speak, Matty Williams. I'm sure we'll see Matty Williams back in centre ring in 2021.
ZZ just caught up in the ropes there. Referee breaks it up, takes him back to centre ring.
Really good back and forth action here in centre ring with these two very vicious ladies. Punch for punch, kick for kick. Yeah, trying to sneak the elbow through. Nicely distanced there by ZZ Rowlandson. As they're getting closer, a bit of a short upward elbow by ZZ. Oh. The elbows are flying with the ladies in centre ring.
But look at Zia. Zia was working those elbows too as well there. Bono. There you go, from over the top.
Shout out once again to First Choice Car Wash for getting behind this bout, as well as all the sponsors for getting behind tonight's fights. I'm sure they're very impressed with the action in centre ring. As both girls going shot for shot, pretty hard to separate them as they come into the clinch, throwing punches and knees. One looking to dominate the other, nothing in it. That's the end of the round one.
End of round number one. Shout out to the good old favourite of Australian and Victorian kickboxing, the Phantom Pax of Shelby is in the house. Now approaching the mighty East Timor Cougars. They're gonna do it in 2021. Go you Cougars, go you good men.
Expectations so high. Is it the bar I set my arms?
Great start, but I can't the fight number nine. Great start, fight number nine there. I think I'd give that round a ZZ. Rollinson from the red corner.
Yeah, I have to agree. They're probably just a little bit more dominant. She made Sia just miss a little bit.
Correct.
But, you know, not too much in it. Definitely early in the story. Let's see what the second round brings us.
Well, if we go by the previous fights here, mate.
Fighters, seconds out.
And
for round two.
As we start round number two, both fighters are centering. Both fighters trying to just suss each other out. ZZ found the right leg. Nice body kick there by ZZ.
Another one of our favourite viewers, always viewing all the broadcasts of Muay Thai Australia, Adam King. Big shout out to Adam King and Road Promotions. Back here to the action centering, Joe Nader. And both girls are just absolutely going for it. Sia trying to establish dominance in the clinch, but ZZ just doing a good job. She keeps looking for that short up elbow from the right hand.
Yeah, yeah, look, when she's in the clinch, she is looking for that elbow. But I think ZZ is probably a little bit more better from just a little bit of a distance. She picks her shots a little bit more cleaner, I think. But they take nothing away from Sia. I mean, she's a tough girl. Starting to find her range.
Height and reach advantage definitely going to ZZ Rowlandson. She comes in with a nice jab, two low leg kick, but Zia saw knock deep, fires back.
She will not sit there, she will come back.
Once again, another fantastically well-matched fight by Mark Jelson, team from Hardcore Promotions. Don't forget, you can get all the action on Hardcore Promotions by following them on social media, both Instagram and Facebook.
Both girls in our center ring, just looking a little bit more tired, looking a little bit tired there, but.
Both girls getting a little cheeky in center ring.
The end of round number two. This fight, five by two rounds.
See her there walking back to the corner with her hands up, really believes she's won that round. Struggling a little bit there to make the decision on the winner. I feel the ice cracking because. You know, I think the red corner now, the advice to give is, you know, maybe keep that long range, keep that long range, pick your shots and just keep working it. Where maybe Z on the other hand has got to just try and come in a little bit more, be aggressive and just try to, you know, take his fight home.
As we head into round number three of this five-rounder, the first of our five-rounders tonight. Starting to up the action.
Riders, seconds out. For round three.
Round three of this five by two-minute round fight. Joe Nader, how do you see it so far?
I think it's pretty even. I think maybe ZZ's just by a touch, not much in it though.
Being the taller fighter, ZZ Rowlandson, I love the way she's using that jab to break the guard and push Sia back. She's doing a really good job there. She gets caught and swept. Nicely done by Sia Sornakdi.
She shakes her head as if there's nothing in it.
ZZ Rowlandson in the pink hair with the red shorts and red gloves, the taller of the two. Sia Sornakdi in the blue now, starting to get a bit aggressive. Meter up in the clinch, in the clinch in the box on the blue corner. You see Dennis O'Day just oying absolutely everything.
Oh, look, as a trainer, when you've got your fighter in your own corner doing damage to the opposition, you do get excited, but it's good to see Zia maybe just stepping forward and taking that fight on and really turning it around a little bit. You know, where ZZ has got the longer reach, but she's got the height. I'd like to see maybe ZZ using that jab and coming to the elbow, just open up and coming of that right elbow.
It's, we love it when the girls start throwing the elbows as ZZ Rowlandson tries for the sweep out, missing the target, going back to the double jab, trying to find her range again. Nice low leg kick, caught but released by Sia Sornakdi. As Sia Sornakdi bullies her again and tries to get her into that corner turnbuckle.
She's trying to work those hands very quickly and it's just throwing them and rushing them, Sia. And just so she can get in there and actually start working in close.
Another very close round. Both fighters really trying to, just one's trying to get on top of the other with their skill set. Nice sharp little leg kick there by ZZ Rowlandson. Zia trying to fake her way in. It's a really good technique to use, fake to close the gap, but you've got to be able to do something with it.
End of round number three. This is a five rounder.
First Choice Car Wash getting behind this fight. Don't forget as well, folks watching at home, on June the 26th, we've got a cracking main event here on Hardcore Promotions. Joe Goodyear taking on Corey Cowboy Smith. I love this kid, Corey Smith. He brings the action every time.
Yeah, he does. I've seen him fight a few times and he's very excited to see. So the next fight for Hardcore Promotions will be June 26th. And I believe it's got the big hands coming to change about the Mooney Valley Racecourse.
Mooney Valley Racecourse, that's got to bring back a few memories for you, Joe Nader.
And for you. Is
seconds out for round four.
As we were saying earlier, the Mooney Valley Racecourse, that was my very first main event, Joe Nader. Do you remember it?
I certainly do, Jono.
It didn't last very long.
That. No, it didn't.
Bad night at the office.
And let's go into round number four. They're only 2 minute rounds, so girls got to really pick up that work rate. But it's easy there trying to work the distance. But you know what? Zia is very aggressive when she comes in close and tries to close the gap. Doesn't give ZZ the opportunity to do what she needs to do. Nice push kick there by ZZ. And the knee goes in there by Zia. Both girls in the clinch, trying to work out the elbows and the knees. Nice knee by ZZ. Elbow. Zia really working that right elbow to the top of the head of ZZ.
Sia Sornakdi really picked up the aggression meter in this round.
And that's the Thai style, though, isn't it? As the rounds go on, they become more aggressive and more dominant. A nice right leg by ZZ. And that's where you need to see that distance and keep kicking us. So you keep her right back. Once again, there's the distance I'm talking about, Jono.
100% ZZ Ramzan trying to get back to using a height and reach with the push kick. Not having much success as Zia ties her up.
Nice, nice for both girls.
Great display of Thai boxing skills here. We're seeing a really good range of all eight weapons here. Not sure, Joe Nader, but Zia Sornati started looking a bit more comfortable in the boxing department. She's not taking as much of a backward step and entering with fist first.
No, she's not. You're right. But as you know, in the Thai boxing, the hands aren't going to score that high compared to everything else. So you might look busy, but you've got to be very effective with what scores better.
Definitely Zia Sornakdi doing a really good job this round. Inside, outside, switching stances.
Correct.
Just rattling the rhythm a bit of ZZ round.
I just find ZZ slowed down a little bit.
Round number four. We're going to be heading to our fifth and final round. First choice Tar Wash gets behind this one. We're going to draw the raffle in a couple of fights time, so it's a great time to buy a ticket, get yourself some fantastic prizes, as well as plenty of merchandise on sale at the front.
Fight number nine between Zia Sornakdi and ZZ Rollinson is proudly sponsored by First Choice Car Wash. It's the last and final round there, Jono.
Fifth and final, and I really got to say, Zia Sornakdi has really started to pull this one back. I really think it's going to come down to this fifth round. Who wants it more?
I think she's put herself back in the race. Yeah, you're correct there, Jono. I think she has. I think it's going to come to the last and final round.
Fighters, seconds out. This is the fifth and final round.
It's which girl wants it more now? Who's going to be the more aggressive and keep working with the higher work rate?
It's great to see all of our Muay Thai community Australia-wide getting behind all these fights, buying the pay-per-views and supporting and watching all the fighters. Shout out to Mr. Muay Thai Grand Prix himself,
nice.
Gavin Fuller.
Nice kick there by ZZ.
As the action continues in centre ring.
Another push kick again.
Oh, a push kick. Here we go.
That's great work there by ZZ.
ZZ really got to keep exposing that long range. And she's got a beautiful push kick. But she's got to put the points on the board.
Look, if she can keep her at range, you know, she can probably just take this fight out. But Zia needs to get in there and just be more aggressive like she was in the previous rounds.
Absolutely. Closing the gap, getting in the face of ZZ Rowlandson as we hear the crowd really getting erupting behind us. Persia Sornakdi tries for the catch and sweep, unsuccessful. Kicking a miss again from Zia. ZZ Rowlandson. We got Zia and ZZ in centering very hard. Oh, very nice counter. Sometimes this is where the mental game comes in. Whatever you got, I got better.
Both girls just eyeing each other out and smiling at each other. Center ring. ZZ coming in very aggressive with the low leg kick. There's another push kick.
Both these girls realize that this fight is very close and every shot, every mistake's going to count.
I don't think ZZ gets very comfortable when Zia comes in too close for her.
No tall fighter does. We hate it, Joe. All you short fighters, stay away and let us just pick you off. It's more fun. It's more fun for us.
There's the elbow there by ZZ. Yeah. Nice right leg kick. Can you hear that thumping sound?
Both girls rally towards the end, and that's the end of the fight. A very close one, Joe Nader.
Oh, another fantastic fight in the books. This is going to be a close one. Which way did you have it? Can I have a representative from First Choice Car Wash in centre ring, please?
If they're going to judge that fight by the last round, it's going to be a tough one to judge, but I think ZZ might have taken that last round, but how the judge see it for the five rounds, I'm not too sure. Once again, I'm not one to put my hand up and call a winner. are the blue corner all happy and cheering with big smiles, and they probably believe that they've won the fight, I'm sure, as the red corner.
Can I have a representative from First Choice Car Wash, your centre ring, please? Oh, we'll keep the music rolling in here. Let's play some beats, play some beats.
As we wait for the judges there to cut the centering with the scorecards, a big shout out to First Choice Car Wash and all the other sponsors of tonight that jumped on board to sponsor Hardcore Promotions.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, what a fantastic fight. The first of our female fights of the evening. And didn't they bring the show? And of course, ladies and gentlemen, once again, we have gone to a split point decision. Your first judge gave the fight 49-46 in favor of the red corner. Your second judge gave the fight 48-47 in favour of the blue corner. And your third and final judge gave the fight 48-47 in favour of, and declaring your winner by split points decision, the red corner, T.T. Rowlandson.
That came down to the last round. I think where Zizi with those push kicks putting Zia down, I think might have just won the fight, a little bit more effective in the judges' eyes. They saw it that way, and you know, full credit to both girls. But I've seen Zia fight before. She's full credit to this lady. She comes out every time, puts on a great show. Both girls put on a great performance tonight, and they'll live the fight again and come back here and perform at their best.